Anyway, Rick Santelli standing by at the CME in Chicago with some breaking economic data. Rick, the numbers, please.
Yes, the numbers have moved higher on initial and continuing claims. Not what we want to see. 853,000 versus a revised 716,716. And 853,000 is the largest since September 18th, the week of September 18th. And if we look at continuing claims, it moved from a slightly revised 5,527,000 to 5,757,000. So it moved in the wrong direction as well. The difference is, of course, is that the lowest initial claims week, 711,000 from November 6th, is, as you can see, benchmarked against 853, and when you look at continuing claims, the lowest it had been was deteriorating, going lower every single week except for this week, so we sort of break that string. Now, for consumer price index, we'll switch gears. The November read, up 0.2. Strip out food and energy, up 0.2. Both 0.1 hotter than expected. And if we look at the wide view, macro view, year over year, up 1.2. Year over year core, up 1.6. And I always like to look at that year over year core. There was 25 straight months from March of 18 to March of 20, where it was 2% or higher. And of course, since then, the highest read we've had is 1.7. The Treasury market's taking this in stride. Down a little bit on yield, up a little bit on price. $118 billion in supply gets completed this week with 30-year bonds.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.